Good day, everyone. Welcome to our channel, Agricra Production of Test Dawanga National Agricultural School. So today, I'm going to share with you about the adlai, which is a good substitute for Aplan rice. So adlai is a good stuff like protein, dietary fiber, and minerals, such as phosphorus, riboflavin, and thiamine. Adlai also is low in glycemic food, making it healthy source of carbohydrates for diabetics. So those people who are suffering for diabetic, so this is now the answer of your health. It is also a gluten-free, known as Chinese pearl or Jacob's pears. Adlai is similar to rice. The grains grows on long stalk of grass. It belongs to grass family like rice, and it is, as I said well ago, it is a good substitute for rice because it contains less carbohydrates. The name Adlai is a boy's name of Hebrew origin, meaning God is just. Then there are so many benefits of producing Adlai. One of the benefits that we will get from adlai is that it will grow in hilly or stony areas. Not only that, it can also be grown together with weeds. So you can, or the adlai can fight the weeds, or it can compete also the growth of the weeds. Adlai also is not prone to attack pests and diseases. So meaning it is resistant to pests and diseases. It will give good yield without applying fertilizer and other chemicals. Grains are not attacked or eaten by birds, especially the maya during the fruiting stage. And even rat and chicken will not attack the grains, for it has long stalk. So that's why we are producing adlai here in Wangan as a substitute for rice, because cereal is one of the major agronomic crops to be studied here in Test Dawanga's under agricultural crop production NC3. So this is now the adlai. So adlai is harvested 4 months after planting. So how you are going to distinguish if this is already matured? So through the color of their grains. So once the grain turns into brown color, so meaning it is ready for harvesting. So in harvesting adlai, so we are going to do this manually. So the tools to be used is either the scythe or the sickle or the pruning shears. So today I am going to use the pruning shears because I think it is very comfortable in using. So in harvesting adlai, just cut the stalk just enough to hold it. Then after cutting this one, so we are going to place this in the container, especially the sack. So once you are going to harvest adlai, see to it that you are going to apply the TLC or the tender loving care, or proper handling of adlai is really very important in order not to cause losses during harvesting. So proper handling is very important for adlai. So this is not attacked by birds and other animals, but once you are not going to handle this properly during harvesting, so it is very sure that you will encounter losing in your production. So the adlai that we raise here in Test Dawangan is really chemically free. So we did not apply fertilizer nor any chemical. So as for realidad, so we only planted 100 grams of adlai seeds, and now you can see that our area were able to produce this adlai. So once it is already cut, so we are going to place this one in the sack in order to protect losses. Then after the sack is filled, so we are going to bring this into the storage area, and that is now the time that we are going to perform the post-harvest activity, which is the threshing. So in threshing the adlai, so we are going to do this one manually. by just doing the twisting of your feet on the harvested adlai. Then after that, we are going to dry that under the heat of the sun. Then once it is dried, so we are going to clean it, then suck, then the adlai is now ready for milling. Then once it is already milled, so we have now the grain of adlai. And again, adlai is a good substitute for rice. And nowadays, adlai is very expensive since the farmers do not know yet about the adlai. So thank you very much, and I hope you will learn more about adlai just prescribed to our channel, Agricraft Production. Since we do not have the mechanical method using the threshing machine, so we are going to do this manually. So the first method of separating the grains of the adlai from the stalk is by doing the twisting, so like this. So we just twist this one until such time that the grains will be separated from the stalk. So like that only, then take another bunch of adlai. So in our dialect, this is called the giok. Now, so you just do it by twisting. Then another method is now the using the another instrument wherein we are going to hampas the adlai stalk. So example of that, so take a bunch of the adlai, then after that, so this one just enough that you can hold this one, then with something, then you just hampas like that. The simple is that you have the mappings also that the grains of the adlai will be added afterwards. Then once you already have the grain from the adlai, so the next step that you are going to do is to perform the cleaning. So this is now the grain of the adlai. So how you are going to do the cleaning of this? Of course, this is now the time that you are going to use the winnower. So you just winnow this one. So this is a winnower. So a winnower comes from a different sizes. So just take the adlai grain. This is one in the winnower so that you can clean this one and keep the adlai. So you will notice that there are some leaves included on this separated grain of the adlai. So what you are going to do this one is to winnow this one. So how to winnow? So this is how you are going to do the winnowing. So once you are going to do the winnowing, situate that you are always against the wind so that the pollen or some of the grasses will not go into your cell. So that is also one way of protecting your cells. So do it continuously until such time that the adlai grain is clean. So clean meaning free from the leaves and other impurities. So always take the grasses and the other stalk and other debris. Okay, so you will notice that this is now the clean adlai grain. So since this is not yet dry, so after the cleaning, so the next step that we are going to do is to dry this one. Our purpose is for milling. But if our purpose is to sell this one immediately, so after cleaning, so we are going to do the sacking and store this one in the warehouse or the storage area. Then after that, we can sell this one in the market. So as of now, so the kilo for this adlai rice or adlai is 350 per kilo. So once it is already milled. Okay, so that is how you are going to do the post-harvest operations of adlai, the same through with the rice. So the operation of the adlai is the same with the rice.